friends, welcome back to the channel The Student's Diary, and today we have a poem to discuss with you. Today we will discuss a poem from 7th standard. The name of the poem is Dad and the Cat and the Tree. It is a comical poem. So now let us discuss the poem and enjoy. Sometimes you know that cats, they climb so high, but while coming down they are stuck up with something. So that time they cannot come down. So they need somebody's help to come down. To bring them down, we need somebody's help. So in this poem, we will see how the comical things happen. How the comedy happens while Dad is attempting to save the cat. And what happens at the end, we will see it. Sometimes we want to show our confidence. Sometimes we become overconfident when looking at the people, when looking at the crowd, we become overconfident. So that is what we feel. We feel that by any means I will do this. Though I know or not, I forget my limitations. So sometimes we forget our own limitations, and it is on account of the crowd. It is on account of the people watching us. We do a lot of things. So that is called something showiness. We are showing something we are to be. So in this poem, actually Dad is not good at climbing. He's not a good climber at all. He doesn't know how to climb. But he's boasting his skills out in front of his wife and his child. So he wants to show his family that he is capable of climbing. But in reality, he doesn't know how to climb. Perhaps he might not have seen somebody climbing a tree, or perhaps he might not have ever tried climbing a tree. But today is the situation which forces him to climb. Why? Because his favorite cat is stuck up on a branch. Let us find out what happens in between. This morning, a cat got stuck in our tree. Dad said, right, just leave it to me. So wife is coming and telling to the husband, he has been stuck up on the tree. So what happens here? Actually, the dad is planning to help him. Now comes, so dad, he wants to show his talent. So he says that, just leave the matter to me. I will handle this. Then what happens? The tree was wobbly, the tree was tall. Mom said, for goodness sake, don't fall. So the tree was shaking. It was not strong enough because it's a growing tree. It has not been mature. Therefore, it was wobbling, it was shaking if you climb, if you attempt to climb. And the tree was also tall but not strong. Whereas mom doesn't know whether dad knows or not. Mom doesn't know that. Dad knows climbing. Whether he knows climbing, she doesn't know. So therefore, she is warning her husband. What? She says, for goodness sake, please don't fall down, because she has to take the consequence. If he falls down, he will break his leg, he may break his hand, he may break anything. But who will be? He will be suffering the pain, but the works will be taken up by the wife. Therefore, she has extra concern for her husband. Now, let us see what happens in the next paragraph. Fall, scoffed dad. Dad bluffed in slapping. He said that, fall, I will fall. That is to from the tree? Never. A climber like me. Child's play, this is. You wait and see. He said that, the climbing a tree, the skill of climbing a tree, just a trick to me. So it is like a child's play for me. As a child wants to play, as a child enjoys to play, it is just climbing a tree is just like a child's play to me. So it is my left hand's duty. Ye mara bahar ka khel hai. So I will not fall. I will anyhow take the cat back and I will also come back. So he assures like that. But what happens meanwhile? Let us see. So he got out the ladder. Now, from this line, you conclude about Dad, whether he's a good climber or not. He got out the ladder from the garden shed. It slipped. He landed in the flower bed. What happened? A climber doesn't need a ladder to climb on the tree. Have you ever seen coconut climbers? How do they climb? Actually, they are the real climbers. They never take a ladder and climb the coconut tree and pluck the coconuts. Nothing of that sort. But here we have a climber in the story. As we know, a climber never needs any ladder to climb a tree. So any fool to climb a tree with the help of a ladder. Even I can climb the heaven if there is a ladder to heaven. Clear? So therefore, by this line, we are sure that dad doesn't know how to climb the tree. He just wants to show his family that he is capable of doing this. He just wants to show his family that he can climb. He just wants to show. Then what happened? He got out the ladder from the garden shed. Then he attempted climbing the tree. So as he was climbing, the ladder slipped down. So when the ladder he fell flat on the earth. He thank God he fell on the flower bed. Therefore, he did not hurt himself. So now, just think what would have been happened. What would be now his response to his wife? His wife warned him to not climb, but he climbed. Now, what would be the response of his wife? Let us see in the next paragraph. Never mind, said Dad, bruising the dirt. He dusted out his shirts and pants and again got ready to climb. As a soldier never fails in his battle, in the same manner, Dad is not ready to accept his weakness. Now he gets up from the dust and he wants to try it once again. Of his hair and his face and his trousers and his shirts. So he cleaned everything. Now, well, we will try plan B. Stand out of the way. Mom said, don't fall again, okay? Whatever. Now that was plan A. What is plan A? Plan A was taking the ladder and attempting the tree. Now the plan B. So that plan failed. Therefore, Dad wanted to try another plan. And he says that this is plan B. So there can be a question in your exams that what is plan A that Dad was trying to, and what is plan B? So now let us come to plan B. What is that plan then? He said, we will try plan B. Stand out of the way. So do you get this sense? We will try plan B, and he says, stand out of the way. That means he is indirectly telling that he will fall again. Therefore, you be away from the path so that I may not fall on you and hurt you. We have to be humorous enough to understand the meaning of the sentences. Then what happened? Then he tried. Then mom again warned, don't fall again, okay? First time you fell, nothing happened. But second time, don't fall. It is not ticket you have taken that if you fall, nothing may happen or nothing will happen. So something may happen or something will happen. Therefore, be careful. Now, fall again, said Dad. Funny joke. So Dad said that, again fall? No, that somehow I slipped and fell down. But now I will not fall. So fall again, he said that, funny joke, you are joking well, my dear wife. So therefore he said, what? Then he swung himself up on the branch, it broke. Then what happened? So the first plan was taking the ladder. Now second plan, what did he do? He got ready, then he jumped and hauled onto the branch of the tree. And he swung. So he was swinging, because when we jump, we are on the motion. So when he swung, the branch again broke down. So the second line of the paragraph was telling that move away from the way. Move away from the way. So that was correct. So Dad maybe knew that he will fall again. Therefore he said his wife, he loves his family. So he said that just move away. And he fell again flat. Dad landed wallop back on the deck. Mom said, stop it. You will break your neck. Then he fell again. Then mom got more concern for her husband and said that, stop it. You no more try climbing the tree. It's enough. Let the cat be there. I want you to be well with me. Then what happened? But dad is not ready to accept his weakness. He wants to show that he can climb. And actually it is a positive thing that we keep on trying. Try and try but never cry. You might have heard it. Therefore dad kept on trying. Then what happened? Rubbish, said dad. Now we will try plan C. Easy as winking to a climber like me. He said that, okay, plan A failed, plan B failed, but plan C is still remaining. Now let us try that. Don't sell those rubbish things. What is rubbish? Mom said that again, don't climb. So that was a rubbish for me. So he wants to prove that he is capable of doing that. Okay, now let us see what was plan C. Then he climbed up high on the garden wall. Guess what? He didn't fall. So now, what was plan C? Plan C was he climbed high on the garden wall. Then from there, he, from the support of the wall, he climbed the tree. Now, he gave a great leap and he landed flat in the crook of the tree trunk right on the cat. So what happened after climbing? The cat is stuck up. Cat is yielding for help. Now dad went and kicked so strongly on the branch that was striking the cat. Then what happened? So when he kicked, the cat gave a so it made a sound like you know that when somebody beats us, oh, we say so like that. The cat cannot say oh like human being. So it gave a yell, means it gave some kind of sound, some kind of noise it made, and sprang to the ground. Directly he jumped from the ground. Please ask Punks to be safe and sound. So he jumped from the top when he kicked, but he was landed safe. Nothing else was happened to the cat. So he was safe and sound. Now what about dad? So it's smiling and smirkling, snug as can be, but poor old dad still stuck up on the tree. What happened? Okay, so when he gave a heavy punch, when he kicked the branch heavily, it is true that the cat got down. So it is safe on the ground now. Now the cat is safe. But what about dad? Because we know how a good climber he is. So in order to climb a tree, he was taking the ladder. He was hanging. Then lastly he tried the wall. Now what would be the situation of dad? What is written? Listen. So it's smiling and smirking, snug as can be. But poor old dad still stuck up the tree. So kya hua? Cat ka jaga hai? Dad le gaya. Dad ka jaga cat liya. So upside down, downside up. When the cat was up, dad was down. Now dad is up and the cat is down. Again, I hope that cat has to go to save the dad, because there is no other person to save. So it is like that, my dear friends. So when we do not know something, so we need to accept that we do not know. Otherwise, we will have to face such situations as dad faced in the poem. So hope you understood it. If you haven't, please comment to us and I will give you some better explanation on that. And the poem is written by Kit Wright. So wonderfully, so beautifully, the poet has explained and he has given a good meaning to through this poem to all human beings, that we should not be proud and we should know our limitations and act accordingly. So thank you so much for listening. See you in the next session. Thank you.